Thank you so much for being here. As Vijay said, this has absolutely been my passion project. I've often said this is a story that made me want to become a filmmaker. Sab kehte hain ki wo ek kahani hoti hai jo sab kehna chahte hain, ye wo kahani hai. This is a story that's lived with me for more than 20 years. It's lived with me because I, at a very young age, fresh out of film school, got an opportunity to actually witness this history through the eyes of the people who made this history. Captain Lakshmi Sehgal, Colonel Gurbakhsh Singh Dhillon, they're no longer here with us now. But I was a young 25-year-old who went with them for 3 months, drove from Singapore through Singapore, Malaysia, Burma to the border of India, retracing the route that the Azad Hind Fauj had taken between 1942 and 1945, and saw firsthand through their eyes what happened during that period. And this was the first time after World War II that anybody from the Azad Hind Fauj was going back to Burma. For them also, it was like, I mean, I think all of us involved in that project, we were all in a trance. Since then, that story never left me. That documentary got made, also titled Forgotten Army. It got me a lot of attention. I often say that's my calling card. My career started with that. But that story just never left me. And when I decided I want to make a story for the bigger screen, that's the first script I wrote. That's my first film script. But I soon realized when I came to Bombay ki itni badi picture mujhe koi dene nahi wala hai, my first film. So I made Kabul Express, which is also based on my documentary. But after every film, I would take the script out and I would wave it in front of Adi Chopra saying, ye banate hai. And every time I was told ki bahut badi hai, bahut ambitious hai, thodi der ke baad banayenge. And that's how it went. I think the test of this story is that whatever happened, however films I made, whether they were, you know, blockbusters or whether they were disasters or whatever I did, this story would just keep coming back until finally, I think destiny has it, but finally it came with Amazon as an original series, and I'm really glad it did, because I can say this without doubt. I've made many films, you know, we all know the kind of films we've done. The kind of support that Amazon gave me for this project, I doubt any film studio could give me. I mean, it was really, you can see the ambition and the scale of this project. We have a beautiful new cast of actors. It's really been mounted at a scale bigger than any of my films. And I dare say, you know, I've done some big films, some big stars, but this far outstrips all of them. And all credit to Amazon. They stood like a rock behind me and made sure that I was able to capture my dream, my vision on screen. So thank you for all being
here. Wow, all smiles. Thanks, Kabir. I'm going to call you back, of course, to talk to us in just a little bit. In the meantime, of course, a big hand, please, for Kabir Khan. This was amazing. Because I've known, and a warm welcome. Hi, Sarvari. This is, of course, hi. This is, of course, my friends of the press. We're actually doing photo ops first, so please, this is your moment under the cameras. Please make sure you're looking your best, posing, smiling. And while you know you do that, I'm asking, of course, Sunny to get ready because he's going to join her very shortly. Thanks.
Well, first up, there's that old saying that when the students are ready, the teacher appears.
Yes. Yeah.
I think you can say that to this story.
Yeah.
I think we're very privileged that we were able to kick off 2020, a new decade, with a story that he's lived with for two decades.
Correct.
You know, so I guess it's kind of prophetic in that sense. But the other thing that we truly believe in is, you know, this is like, I mean, the various kinds of biryani, right? This is the dampokta version of it.
Wow.
Right? So as long as Kabir took to cook it, we said it's fine because he's a great chef. So we had no doubts about that. But it's really important to understand that for us, our driving philosophy is to become the preferred choice for content creators. Give them all the tools and the resources to think in a very unconstrained manner. You know, think about compelling stories that need to be told and bring their vision and support their vision. I think we're very clear about this in the way we work. I must admit that it's not all peaches and cream. Kabir has been very kind. There have been difficult conversations that we've all had, but all towards the same purpose of telling the best version of the story there is. And so I guess that's really been the journey. And we are incredibly patient people, generally speaking.
Wonderful. Can I just have a sip of water for my cast, please, first? Thank you. It's unfair, no, to ask question and answers without offering water.
Thank you.
So thirsty. TJ, that was fun. Seeing you gulp that pani. Also, can you take this plastic away? Yeah, please. Because they did not bring it with them. Otherwise, they'll say tomorrow that they are promoting plastic and bring this script around with people. And then finally, when it came together, and you know, where all did you shoot? And do you remember the locations that you went to?
Yes, of course. The bulk of the series was actually shot in Thailand. Most of the drama unfolds in Burma. That's where most of the battles that the Azadins fought happened. But Burma, because of political reasons, we're not, you know, able to shoot there. So we recreated most of those locations in Thailand. A lot of locations which are on the border with Burma and Thailand. And there, some of the battle took place along the rivers, so that was like the river Irrawaddy in Burma, which we recreated on River Kwai in Thailand, yeah, famous for bridge on the River Kwai. A lot of the battles that took place in the hills outside Imphal were recreated on the border with Burma and Thailand. It was used to be like a 2-hour drive from Chiang Mai, and then another sort of half an hour, 40-minute trek. You can see the cast all nodding. So it was great because I have always loved shooting on real locations. I mean, I think it's my documentary background. You put me on a set and I'm like a dead duck. But I come alive on locations. And it was great. I think for the cast, it was also like a boot camp every day as soldiers, you know, because you had to put your backpacks on, you carry your guns and walk up the hills. By the time you were ready to shoot, they were all looking and feeling like soldiers.
Yeah. You know, which brings me to casting, because, you know, normally you'd like to look at troopers for a project like this. They don't have to be just actors. The ask is a little more than that. Could you tell us or take us through the casting process when it started? What were you looking for?
You're absolutely right. It's not just about how they look and how they act. It's also about attitude and that passion to, and this is something, and not just this project, I think every project needs to, you know, look for actors who have that passion to take your vision onto the screen. And with the, I mean, these guys are really troopers. I mean, we've been to everything. Calamity Jane here has fallen everywhere, in the rivers, on the hills. But it was really tough, right? It was, as you can see, those locations are real locations. They're not, you know, locations that have been recreated in studios. You're actually jumping into the river when a 18-foot python has been like sighted just an hour before that. So we had to put people and make sure the python doesn't come and, you know, hungry python for my cast will have continuity issues for me. You know, climbing up those hills, I don't think anybody has really shot on those locations before. And a lot of the stuff is not even in the test. So much material that we couldn't put it all into the trailer. There's so many other locations that are really tough locations to reach and shoot in. But I think it's really because of the cast that I had that we were able to do it. I mean, and to top it all, we had a blast doing it. It was a party. We had a lot of fun shooting this. I think the whole, you know, usually, and I say this often, that sometimes the goodwill for the story comes and sort of, you know, takes the crew along with it. And I think the goodwill of the Azadin Forge was with us. Yeah. Their blessings were with us. It's a sacred story for me. It's like a story that I had to tell. It's almost like a promise I had made to Captain Lakshmi Sehgal and Dhillon Saab that this, I will tell this story one day at a larger level. And I think their goodwill carried us through.
Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you so much for so many insights and actually so many talking points. I'm going to ask you, Sunny. Captain Suri, just love the lines, dialogue bazi. Matlab, I love dialogue bazi. That's who I am. I'm a total filmy kid. And when you say stuff like go back and all, I'm like, yeah, buddy, you just go back. Like, I'm going to shout as well, you know, when this happens. So let's go back to when you read, you know, the scenes or let's go back to the moment where you said yes to this. Was it very exciting or was it just a chance or a dream to work with somebody who you wanted to work with? What made you say yes to the Forgotten Army?
Oh, it was actually everything coming together because I was shooting for another film when I got a call to audition for this part. And it was a great opportunity actually to be a part of the story that we have only heard about very little, read about very little. So we gave the audition. Of course, Kabir sir liked it and we were on board. We started having reading sessions and I was just blown away by the sheer knowledge that he has about the whole subject. And that was the moment, the first day of our reading was the moment I realized how special this story is for Kabir sir, how passionate he is about the story. And that puts an added responsibility on us as actors to portray those characters, right? So it was just, I mean, our one point of reference was Kabir sir. We used to be like, sir, acha ye batao ye kaise hua tha, sir, aage peeche upar niche sab khol ke rakh dete the. And but he's a brilliant storyteller. Yeah, it was just a brilliant, brilliant opportunity to be a part of this. So thanks.
That's cute. Sharmini, I think this is pretty cool because there's a debut that we're making today and it's with Amazon Original and with the one and only Kabir Khan. And your role is so integral. Like, you know, even when he talks about just thanking the people who inspired him to make this piece, you know, how did it feel to represent a woman soldier? Like, did you draw inspiration from someone you knew?
I mean, don't you agree that all women are soldiers at their core? I think that's true.
She had no idea. I'm going to ask her this question. She had no idea. Wow. Well fielded.
Yeah, so I think everyone you've met in your life, I think I drew inspiration from everyone. But of course, I think Kabir sir was our one point of contact where we went and we asked him information about things. I mean, you don't need the internet. Kabir sir can, he's good enough.
He is the internet.
Yeah, he is the internet. And I don't know, I'm just really grateful and I'm very excited for the show. And thank you, Kabir sir, for letting us be a part of his vision. You know, I think that's the most special thing for us.
What was it that you learnt new? Like something that you did not know? Like I know, for example, poor actors, they, you know, they don't get enough credit. You know, they have to learn how to shoot a rifle. They have to sit on horses with braced backsides and they've got to really run and jump and make it look like, you know, and still make it look really nice while you do it. So what is it that you learned through this?
How to handle a gun, of course. I mean, we had dummy guns, but we also had real guns which had shell cases in them, not the bullet, but we did use the real guns for the shot that you just saw. Yeah.
And of course, I started off the question saying, what a fun debut. What do you have to say about that?
I'm grateful. That's all. I feel very grateful today.
That's amazing. DJ Bhanu, one second. You've already been christened the, what did you call her?
Calamity Jane.
Calamity Jane. Yeah. Now tell us, first, I've stopped all my questioning. Tell us one of your favorite falls.
तो वो जो ट्रेलर में दिख रहा है वो एक जगह जहाँ पर वो ऐसे घूर के देख रही हैं और आगे चलते हुए जा रही हैं तो कुछ ऐसा हो गया था कि गड्ढा सिर्फ वहीं पे था जहाँ पर हम चल रहे थे तो सारे लोग कहीं से सेफ थे वो
गड्ढे हिल के इनके रास्ते में आ जाते हैं
जी नहीं मैं हमेशा कहती हूँ वो लौकिक समस्याओं का हल है या लौकिक समस्या इसका कोई हल नहीं है आपको गड्ढे में गिरना ही पड़ेगा तो हर बार मतलब सर शूट कर रहे हैं और हम वहीं जाकर गिर रहे हैं वो कुछ 8 टेक हुए हैं उस पर और ऐसा भी नहीं कि पोजीशन चेंज हो रही है कि नहीं अच्छा तुम वो बाजू में चल लो तो कि नहीं कैमरा वहाँ सेट है तो यहीं से जाना पड़ेगा और फिर हमें कहा गया कि अच्छा एक काम करो ना कुछ थोड़ा फिगर आउट कर लो. अब गड्ढे को कैसे फिगर आउट करोगे, वो भी ऐसा नहीं कि दिख रहा है, वो तो पानी के अंदर है. तो हाँ बस वो उसमें 8 बार गिरना हुआ, इतना बड़ा चोट था उसके बाद और मतलब इतनी बड़ी सी चोट थी.
No, I love it. I love it. Chhattisgarh ki Rani is what we used to know you as, by the way. She's like, oh my God, how do you know this? No, it's amazing. You know, you used to be a supermodel. You've also been a Miss India runner-up, which I think is pretty commendable.
A finalist.
And now, of course, you know, you're making this acting foray. Been very exciting as a journey for you personally, hai na?
Ji, ji, bilkul.
Congratulations. Welcome to show business, as they say, yeah. Haan. Is there anything else you want to say? मुझे ऐसे क्यों लग रहा है कि तुम्हें और कुछ बोलना है?
नहीं नहीं कुछ नहीं कहना है, मतलब ट्रेलर देख के तो निशब्द हो गए थे हम ऐसे कि ठीक है, मतलब आंखें भरा इतना ठीक है. और इट्स अ जर्नी व्हेन यू पुट टुगेदर, इट्स लाइक बेयर फीट टू हाई हील्स एंड द बेस्ट थिंग आई थिंक हाउ आई गॉट दिस रोल एंड एवरीथिंग, इट्स अ वेरी ब्यूटीफुल स्टोरी विद कबीर सर.
प्लीज हमें बताइए, आई'd लव टू नो.
नहीं ऐसे ही मतलब शायद पहले दिन ही उन्होंने कुछ सबके बीच में खड़े थे, उन्होंने कहा था अच्छा ऑडिशन है आपका, और हमें लगा था, और उन्होंने कहा था भानु दैट वॉज अ ग्रेट ऑडिशन और हमें लगा था जिनको हमारा नाम याद है तो हम और हमने मुंडी हिलाई तो उन्होंने भी मुंडी हिलाई तो वो एक कनेक्शन सर. हाँ वो मुंडी वाला मूवमेंट था, जैसे हमने ऐसे कर दिया उन्होंने भी कर दिया और फिर वो चले गए तो वो बात रह गई एकदम अंदर तक. और फिर उसके बाद फिर वो सिलसिला चल पड़ा और फिर उनकी कहानियों का और किस्से सुनने की आदत हो गई और फिर ये तो सबसे बेहतरीन किस्सा था शायद.
दिस इज रियली ब्यूटीफुल एंड प्योर. आई जस्ट थिंक आई नो योर आईज आर वेट राइट नाउ बट आई टोटली गेट इट. आई मीन इवन दो I shouldn't get it because I am not in your position, but I do. A big hand, ladies and gentlemen. What a beautiful story. All right, up next, Rohit. Hi. Yar, kya short tha yar wo. Mujhe aur dekhna hai. Tumhara kirdar mujhe aur dekhna hai. Mujhe batao. You know, what was your prep like? You know, what was it to be this intense? What was it to be soldiers? I want to know everything. Tell me.
So, main Captain Arshad kar raha hu, and my journey same as Sodi minus the love angle.
तुम्हारा लव एंगल मेरे साथ है, क्या बात कर रहे हो यार, ऐसे कैसे काट दिया मुझे
तुमने.
शिपिंग फॉर देम.
सो या तो प्रिपरेशन थे जैसा कि सनी ने बताया, बहुत सारी वर्कशॉप्स हुई, उसने बहुत हेल्प की, हम रीडिंग सेशंस हुए, डिस्कशंस होते थे बहुत सारे. और प्रिपरेशन में मुझे लगता है सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट, आई थिंक हम सब अग्री करेंगे इस बात पे कि मुझे ऐसा लगा सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट था हमारी यूनिफॉर्म. यूनिफॉर्म हमारा कैरेक्टर बन गई थी. सो आफ्टर ए पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम, आफ्टर अ फ्यू डेज ऑफ शूटिंग, हम जब यूनिफॉर्म पहनते थे ना, वो एक ऐसे कहावत सुनी थी कि वर्दी पहन के कुछ होता है, वो बटन लगाते ही एक प्राइड का सेंस जो आता था ना, सो वो एक ऐसी फीलिंग है जो शायद शब्दों में बयान नहीं की जा सकती. तो प्रिपरेशन का एक मेजर पार्ट अगर उसको दो हिस्सों में बांटें तो एक तो वर्कशॉप्स जो हमने की, बूट कैंप, रीडिंग, और दूसरा था वो हमारी कॉस्ट्यूम्स, उसका बहुत योगदान है मुझे लगता है.
इफ आई जस्ट गो अराउंड एंड क्विकली आस्क यू, यू नो योर मोस्ट फेवरेट मेमोरी ऑफ बीइंग पार्ट ऑफ दिस. अब ये दूसरों तक जाएगा और ये उनके जहन में, यू नो देन देयर विल बी रिव्यूज, देयर विल बी वर्ड्स एंड देयर विल बी लॉट ऑफ दैट. उससे पहले ये सिर्फ आपका है, यू नो. तो इस मोमेंट में दिस इज जस्ट still yours. What is the one word that you know that you want to leave your fantastic friends from the press with? Sunny, we'll start with you.
Wow, do you want to take that?
Haan madam, main ek aur baar bol dal rahi hu.
Sorry, this was, I actually always do this. Jab bhi main stump ho jata hu kisi question se, I just ask her, do you want to take that? So that I get
ladies first. Ladies first.
Sorry, what was the question?
Okay, what's the one word that comes to mind?
The one word that comes to my mind is just us being grateful somewhere, because this story is not a very ordinary story, and it is a great opportunity. It's a great responsibility to share a chapter of our history with today's generation, which has been somewhere forgotten. And it just kind of leaves you with the feeling that, you know, the reason why it is the forgotten army is because it just leaves you with the feeling that just be grateful that people have laid their lives for the freedom that we have today.
Correct.
So, you know, yeah, that's
grateful. That's your word.
Yeah.
All right. Shravi?
I think blessed in a blessed. Way because we're portraying characters not just, I mean, they're not just written, but they're actually someone's real lives. So I think somewhere they blessed us, and that's how we all got. That's exactly how I'm taking inspiration from Kabir sir, from what he just said.
I'm seeing hashtags, you know, like hashtags, yeah, grateful, hashtag blessed.
We are the social media generation, right?
Social media generation. Kabir, you and I don't fall into that generation, hopefully. No. Yeah, so but we'll still give them a word. Tell me.
For me, it's impossible to summarize any of these emotions into a word. It's, as I said, for me, if there is a word, it's magical because of what I experienced. And finally, you know, I'll actually tell you a little story, which is something which is it in a certain sense shows what this series is all about. When I was doing the documentary with Captain Lakshmi Sehgal and Dhillon Saab, and I said that's the first time after World War II that they were going back to Burma, and what was very essential for them was at the last stand of the INA. This is after the Battle of Imphal was over and they were retreating. But when Netaji gave them the second war cry, which was "Tum mujhe khoon do, main tumhe azadi dunga," is they decided to stand till the end. And their last stand was in a place called Mount Popa. Captain Lakshmi Sehgal was never there. Her husband, who she married after the war, I mean, this love story is also inspired partly by their love story. Captain Prem Kumar Sehgal, he was there, and Dhillon Saab was there. In fact, it was for the actions at Mount Popa that Dhillon Saab, Captain Colonel Sehgal, and Shahnawaz Khan were put on trial at the Red Fort trials. So in Mount Popa, they'd been reduced to a guerrilla fighting unit, and they were operating out of a cave in the jungles. And Lakshmi Sehgal used to say, "All my life I've heard about this cave at Mount Popa." And Colonel Sehgal was so obsessed by it that their house in Kanpur is called Popa. And she used to joke, she said, "You know, I was afraid that if we had a son, he'd call him Popa. Fortunately, we have a daughter and he called her Subhashini." So she said, "I want to see this cave." And similarly, Dhillon Saab, because Dhillon Saab said, "You know, me and my men used to live out of that cave. It used to be a natural air raid shelter. Wahan pani tha, stream tha. And we used to always go and hide there when the air raids used to take place." So for him, it was hugely emotional also. And Colonel Sehgal had picked up a small Buddha statue from the jungle and put it inside that cave, saying that this Buddha will protect us from the enemy. So we reached there, and the backdrop to us doing that documentary was that we were getting a lot of trouble from the Burmese military government. They were trailing us, tracking us, they put us under house arrest for 14 days, taken away our cars. There was a lot of problem. And towards the end of our journey is where we were in Popa, and both Captain Sehgal and Colonel Dhillon just wanted to search for this cave. And we spent 1 day, 2 day, 3 day. And you know, you're talking about thick Burmese tropical jungles. It was almost impossible, like finding a, you know, needle in a haystack. But they persisted. So by 5 baje utke nikal jate the jungle mein, and I used to keep following them till I finally told them that, you know, I don't think it's possible to find this cave. It's impossible. After 55 years, how are you going to locate a cave? And you know, we've got the Burmese soldiers following us. We need to get out of this place. But they said, "Ek aur din do." And on the fourth day, when we were going in, they finally found the cave. And it was an unbelievable moment, just watching them go into that dark cave, and there was no light. So we ran back to the nearest village, got some matchsticks and candles, lit candles. We went deep inside the cave, and in the cave, that little Buddha statue that was lying there, it was still there, at the same place that Colonel Sehgal had put it. You can imagine what they were going through. And then they reached out, and the soldiers used, because they could not send letters home, they used to write letters and put it under the Buddha statue. And we also found this beautiful cave and used that cave as inspiration for a scene in the series. So I just want to tell this story because it's this emotion and this sort of journey that has led to every scene in the Forgotten Army. Everything you see, I've taken from the experiences, either what I witnessed with them or what they told me. And therefore, I've always said, it is a magical, sacred moment for me.
And we will always want you to tell stories to us like this. Look at us, we're all a bunch of kids right now listening to Kabir tell us a story. Thank you, that was magical. Oh, the one word that you're left with.
Matlab कहानी के बारे में पहले से पता था थोड़ा बहुत क्योंकि स्कूल में थोड़ी बहुत पढ़ाई की थी और उसके अलावा बहुत सी किताबें पढ़ी हैं इतिहास के ऊपर पसंद था तो पर जब ये मौका मिला और जब स्क्रिप्ट मिली पहली बार हाथ में नीली किताब मिलती है यहाँ पर. तो एक तो वो मूवमेंट था कि अच्छा आपको मिला हुआ है, इनसे मिला हुआ है. अब जो भी इसकी मंजिल है वो आपको पसंद आना या आपके मन में हलचल पैदा करना है, पर हमारे हिस्से में तो हमारे सफर का सुख है और वो सुखन काफी है.
क्या तो बात है, क्या बात है, बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत बढ़िया. थैंक यू फॉर दैट. रोहित,
मुझे लगता है एज एक्टर यू नो देर आर सर्टेन कैरेक्टर्स हु एड व्हाट यू कॉल इट ट्रेट्स एंड फ्लेवर टू योर लाइफ एंड दे नेवर एवर लीव यू. अर्शद इज दैट टू मी. या सो थैंक यू सो मच कबीर सर फॉर क्रिएटिंग अर्शद.
दैट्स ग्रेट, दैट्स ग्रेट. I'll tell you, I mean, Vijay, I want you to tell me your word also. But I'll tell you my word before you tell me your word. And my word is binge. Because that's my favorite word. And I know I'm going to be doing that exactly on the 24th. And I think what you've given us truly is, you know, for my lonely existence, you've given me a plan for 26th of January, which I think is great. Varna hum kya karenge? Chutti ke din sabse zyada rota hai insaan. Ki aaj mere koi plan nahi. Main kya karunga? So no, on a lighter note, of course, binge watching it and on this first sort of holiday, and also such a great, is there a word that you have in mind that you want to tell us?
Yes, and that's timeless.
Okay.
I think what we've created is going to entertain not just my generation but my kids and hopefully their kids. And my belief is that we finally have a piece of content that will be spoken of in the same breath as Saving Private Ryan and Dunkirk. Wow. Okay. So I'm really grateful that this one stands on the shoulders of giants. I believe that.
You know, there's so little that we know of our own history sometimes, and sometimes it takes, you know, a storyteller, master storyteller, to bring that history forefront. And I think with that, it justifies the fact that we're going to watch this across 200 countries and territories.
That's right.
On the 24th of January.
That's right.
Guys, I don't think that this would deserve anything less than a resounding applause in the room, so please give them a huge hand. Can I please request one to kindly, you know, be ready, because this is the moment I give you the Forgotten Army Azadi Ke Liye, the cast, crew, and of course joined by Vijay, and that is of course representing Amazon Prime Video.